हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ गरिमा. दिस सेशन इज़ फॉर बीएससी फोर्थ ईयर एंड द टॉपिक इज़ ग्रुप डायनेमिक्स. द वर्ड डायनेमिक मीन्स फोर्स. द टर्म ग्रुप डायनेमिक्स रेफर्स टू द फोर्सेज ऑपरेटिंग इन ग्रुप्स. इन टुडेज एक्सप्लोजन ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी कम्युनिकेशन कंटिन्यूज टू बी अ कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस. ग्रुप डायनेमिक्स कैन बी अ वेरी पॉजिटिव एंड हेल्पफुल वेयर टीम मेंबर्स सपोर्ट ईच अदर एंड डू वॉट इज़ बेस्ट. इट कैन ऑल्टरनेटिवली बिकम डिस्ट्रक्टिव इफ इंडिविजुअल्स आर अलाउड टू कंटिन्यू विद मोर सेल्फिश बिहेवियर्स सच एज नेवर हेल्पिंग समवन एल्स, मेकिंग देयर पर्सनल लाइफ एंड पर्सनल प्रॉब्लम्स परमिएट देयर वर्क, बींग नेगेटिव अबाउट एवरीथिंग दैट हैपन्स और कंप्लेनिंग ऑल द टाइम. द नर्स मैनेजर हैज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन दिस सिचुएशन बिकॉज इट मे बी नेसेसरी टू काउंसल इंडिविजुअल्स एग्जिबिटिंग नेगेटिव बिहेवियर टू अचीव पॉजिटिव ग्रुप डायनामिक्स. डेफिनेशन. ग्रुप डायनामिक्स मे बी डिफाइंड एज अ सोशल प्रोसेस बाय विच पीपल इंटरैक्ट फेस टू फेस इन ऑल इन स्मॉल ग्रुप्स. Another definition, group dynamics refers to the attitudinal and behavioral characteristics of a group and it is concerned how groups form, their structure and process and how they function. Need for a group. First is group help in making participative management more effective. Second is group of all kinds and types help by cooperating in all the matters related to quality care and human relations to work effectively in the health organization. Third is any individual cannot perform each and every task. Group efforts are required for its completion. Fourth one is a group can judge in a better way as compared to an individual. Fifth one is in a group individuals communicate with each other, discuss their work performances and take suggestions from each other to make it better. Then sixth one is group efforts affect an individual, her attitude and behavior. Then seventh one is group has the ability to satisfy the needs of its members. And last one is when accomplishing task, all members of a group together use their creative and innovative ideas than a single individual. Characteristics of a groups. In this first one is a goal-oriented activities. In this, groups have goal-oriented activities. They share some common goals. Second is well-organized. In this, the groups are well-organized and tend to bind roles to play. Rules, regulation and set of norms that gives unique identity. Then third is interdependency. In this, the members of a group are interdependent to each other. The influence of each other's action that brings changes in their personalities. Fourth one is power structure. In this, the leaders or a members of the group exercise the power that may be autocratic or democratic in nature, can be hierarchical where power is vested in the highest authority of the group, or vertical where it is vested in every member of the group. Fifth one is a group structure. Group structure is a pattern of relationships among members that hold the group together and help in achieving assigned goals. The groups exhibit different types of relationship that vary from group to group and the purpose of having groups. Sixth one is size of the group. In this, a group has a definite number of members. The group size varies. It may range from two to many members. Then last one is a group functions. In this, each group should have functions. The functions of the group vary depending on its formation. It is formed to have self-interest or to achieve some specific task or for socio-emotional support. Then characteristics of effective group. First one is democratic atmosphere. Second is involved and interested group members. Third is consensus in decision making. Fourth is clarity in task, roles and assignments. Fifth one is there is emotional stability. Sixth one is a regular assessment of performance, purpose and process. And last one is a constructive criticism. Principles of group dynamics. First is the members of the group must have a strong sense of belonging to the group. Second is changes in one part of the group may produce stress in another person, which can be reduced only by eliminating or allowing the change by bringing about readjustment in the related parts. Third is the group arises and functions owing to common motives. Fourth is groups survive by placing the members into functional hierarchy and facilitating the action towards the goals. Fifth one is the intergroup relations, group organization and member participation is essential for effectiveness of a group. Sixth is information relating to needs for change, plans for change and consequences of changes must be shared by members of a group. objectives of a group dynamics. In this, first is to identify and analyze the social processes that impact on group development and performance. Second is to acquire the skills necessary to intervene and improve individual and group performance in an organizational context. Last one is to build more successful organizations by applying techniques that provide positive impact on goal achievement. Types of groups. Usually there are two types of work group. First is formal group, second is informal. First is formal group. Formal groups are established by an organization to achieve organizational group, to achieve organizational goals and overall organizational mission. These are designed and planned by top management to achieve organizational goals. These are also known as functional groups. The main focus of these groups is on the performance of job and coordination of members are controlled through process, procedures, etc. These groups are permanent in nature. They have to follow rules, regulations and policy of the organization. Formal groups may take the form of command groups, task groups and functional groups. A formal organizational groups includes departments such as the personal department, the quality control department and nursing department. Second is task group. Task groups are the groups formed by an organization to accomplish a narrow range of purposes within a specified time. These groups are temporary in nature. They also develop a solution to a problem or complete its purpose. Informal committees, task forces, and work teams are included in task groups. The organization, after specifying a group membership, assigns a narrow set of purposes such as developing a new product, evaluating a proposed grievance procedure, etc. Third one is informal group. Informal groups are created in the organization because of social and psychological forces operating at the workplace. These are resulted as a natural outcome at the workplace in the form of associations, unions, etc. These are the groups formed by the employees themselves at the workplace while working together. The organization does not take any active interest in their formation. The coordination of work is observed through group norms. Informal groups are very effective and powerful. These groups work as an informal communication network, forming a part of the grapevine to the organizations. They are also like a powerful force which an organization cannot avoid. Informal groups are of following types. And this first one is the interest group. Interest groups are the groups formed to attain a common purpose. Employees coming together for payment of bonus, increase in salary, medical benefits and other facilities are the examples of interest groups. Second is membership group. Membership groups are the groups of individuals belonging to the same profession and knowing each other. For an example, teachers of the same faculty in a university. Then third is friendship group. Friendship groups are the groups of individuals belonging to same age group, having similar views, tastes and opinions. These groups can be in the form of clubs and associations. Last is reference group. Reference groups are the group where individuals shape their ideas, beliefs, values, etc. They want support from the group. Based on intimacy, there are two types of groups, primary group and secondary group. Primary groups are characterized by small size, face-to-face interaction and intimacy among members of group. For an example, family, neighborhood group. Secondary groups are characterized by large size, individual identification with the values and beliefs prevailing in them rather than cultural interaction. For an example, occupational association and ethnic group. Other types of groups are, first is social groups. Social groups refers to integrated system of interrelated psychological group formed to accomplish defined objectives. For an example, political party with its many local political clubs, friendship group. Second is reference groups. Reference groups are one in which they would like to belong. Then third is functional groups. Groups in this, the individuals work together daily on similar tasks. Last one is problem-solving groups. Problem-solving groups focuses on specific issues in their areas of responsibility, develops potential solution, and often empowered to take action. Purposes of groups. groups are very important in the organizational setup. They have various purposes. First one is organizational functions. Organizational functions are, first one is to assist in accomplishing complex independent tasks. Second is to help in generating new ideas and solutions. Third is to coordinate interdependent efforts. Fourth is to provide problem solving mechanisms for various problems. Fifth is to aid in implementing complex decisions. Sixth is to encourage a feeling of cohesiveness among group members, enhancing the capabilities of group members. Seventh is to provide opportunities for individual members to grow. Eighth is to socialize and train new entrants. Ninth is to develop the leadership qualities. Tenth is to help members become self-reliant. 11th is to increase participation of members at all levels. And last one is to organize, utilize and exploit ideas of group members. Second is individual functions. Individual functions are, first one is to satisfy the individual need for affiliation. Second is to enhance individual's self-esteem and sense of identity. Third is to provide opportunity to individuals to test and share their perceptions of social reality. Fourth one is to reduce individuals' anxiety and feeling of insecurity. And last one is to provide solutions to the problems arising due to interpersonal relationship. Next is elements of group behavior. First is activity. When a person does something, for an example, talks, runs, manipulates machinery and so forth, he is said to perform some activity. Second is interaction. By interaction, we mean a communication or contact between two or more persons, so that the activity of one responds to the activity of the other. Every conversation is an interaction. It is usually important to note by whom they are initiated and whether two or more persons are simultaneously involved. Third is beliefs. A belief or feeling which an employee must have in order to perform the assigned task is called required sentiment. The belief or feeling which an employee brings with him into a group because of his life outside it and his personal background is known as a given sentiment. When given sentiments pertain to ideals and aspirations which are desirable, they are called values. Thus, a value is an ultimate idea of what is desirable, such as belief in fair treatment, good pay, or freedom from being pushed around. Fourth one is norms. Norm is a particular kind of emergent, namely an idea or belief about what the activities, sentiments, or interactions in a particular group should be. Norms develop in any group with greater or less degree of consensus, and they serve to define how one should behave in selection to outsiders, other members, the job, and the emergent non-work activities. The extent to which a group member upholds such norms help to define his internal rank or social standing in the group. Last one is sentiments. Sentiments can be defined as an idea, belief, feeling about the work and others involved in it. Next is problems of group. First is lack of qualified leader. Second is lack of participation. Third is lack of interest in programs. Fourth is membership. Fifth is disorderly meetings. And last one is a poor group relation. Now the stages of group development. In this, first one is forming. Forming is the first stage of group development, which is developed with getting acquainted with group members. During this stage, people have a sense of uncertainty, awkwardness, and anxiety. The people are not sure of what to do and how to do. In this, there is superficial level of harmony and cooperation. This stage serves the purpose of getting the group started off the ground in terms of motivation and commitment. The norms are established during this stage. These norms can be established by, first one is stating, in this, explaining people how to behave. Second is modeling. In this, demonstrating behavior for others to adopt. Last one is importing. In this, bringing the behavior and customary in other social situations. These three methods need to be combined in order to work effectively. Second is storming. In this, the group is formed. People are acquainted with each other. The group members now begin to feel comfortable enough with their new environment. Each person in the group wants to have individual importance and influences the group. During this, the responsibility can be shifted to group as they have moved into moderate level of maturity. Third one is norming. During this stage, problem in the group start taking responsibility for resolving conflict and strengthening the friendship. There is growth of affection and establishment of personal relationships. It means during this stage, group members are becoming personal. Fourth is performing. This stage is characterized by working together, that is harmony among the group members, decision making and problem solving is shared in the group. The group is mature enough to attend to its own needs in terms of task and relationship matters. Last one is transference. During this stage, the group members are able to transfer the things which they have learned about themselves and being in a group back to their regular lives. Next is techniques for managing group dynamics. First one is, in this, there are several techniques which assist the facilitator in managing the agenda and group dynamics. The facilitator has to use different techniques for different situations. The various techniques used are, first one is pacing. Pacing means keeping a flow. It is a responsibility of facilitator to choose such techniques which encourage balance and cooperation. Second is listing. Listing is a way of adding the person's name in the list of speaker by silently signaling the facilitator. Third one is equalizing participation. In this, allowing the participants of group to speak at a time in order so as to have fair distribution of attention towards all. Last one is taking a break. It is a good to give a 5 minutes break after 20 to 30 minutes in the group discussions or debates. Thank you.